Hey, I got a teachable moment. Let's come on over here. Teachable moment. Teachable moment. All right, so I watched the jerk from behind the head. What? First of all, why do I do jerks from behind the head? It forces me to go straight up. My elbows are where automatically? They're down. They're already externally rotated, and I get to usually really drive the heck out of them. But the reason that I give my athletes jerks behind the neck is because of confidence. Now, my son's best jerk ever, clean and jerk, was 224. It's about three pounds shy of 500. But he could jerk from behind the head 550. Do you think he ever worried about jerks? Because I developed in him a confidence. Now, the jerk has got to be balanced, guys. And so we identified a young lady that was driving her leg too far back. She wasn't stepping into the bar. She was making the lift. But if you put the bar in front of her and the back leg goes too far back, she drives her body away from the bar, not into the bar. So come on up here. This is my young lady, by the way. All right. So what I did with her is that I asked her to go down into a lunge. Let's go ahead and mimic that, though. I asked her to go down into the lunge, and I asked her to put the back leg on the ground, and I wanted to make sure that the knee was stacked over the ankle, and I wanted to make sure that the hip and the knee were aligned, and I wanted this toe. I wanted the toe to be a little bit more flexible, so I did a guesstimate of about an inch more. If it was more, if she had better range, where's Kelly? If I had better range, where's that ball I want you to work on her for? If she had better range of motion, then I wouldn't have to have guessed. So from this position then, I marked her heel, I marked the hip, and I marked the toe. So now go ahead and stand. And what do you notice? Go ahead and get out of the way for just a second. What do you notice here? Pretty close. You may be some deviations, but that's our starting point. So now the goal is that when we go from the clean and jerk, the bar is going to be right here, right? When we go from the back, the bar is in perfect position. So I've got to make my body move that direction so that the bar is in perfect position from the back, right? And if she drives her heel too far back, what happens? She drives her body away from the bar. So with her, I got to try to correct that problem. So go ahead and straddle this. And this is where I just start. It's about a straddle right there. And she just practices footwork, dip and drive. Okay? I don't want her to be thinking too freaking much. Let me do the thinking. You do the thing there. And I'd say, not bad. Because the key for her is stepping where? Forward and not too far back. So if she steps forward and shortchanges herself there, good. Okay, one more time. Okay, she's anal. So, all right, so that's not bad. Now, when she recovers, just like she did there. So if you find yourself missing jerks and forward, chances are you're probably not driving into the bar enough. Check your back leg. Your back leg probably, her back leg was like way back here, and her front leg was way here. She got away with it because the bar was already where? Perfect position. I do this drill because I want to make sure I got fast hands, fast feet. The elbows are down, but I'm really looking at the dip and the drive for fast hands, fast feet. But I have to be aware of that back foot pushing her away from the bar. Does that make sense? All right, let's go. Let's continue on. Good job.